In addition to what Arun is mentioning, there are a couple of things. In fact, in the earlier session, someone mentioned about some reading of some news material in Economic Times about something to do with the patents, right? So many a times what we see is relative usage of the words. It could be patents, trademarks, copyrights is actually misused. I see in a newspaper saying that Tirupati Laddu is patented. So you really can't really a patent a process of doing a, I mean, at the best you can claim a geographical indication. So most of the times we see entrepreneurs misusing the term. The idea is intellectual property, yes, of course we know, but the rights attached to each of this intellectual property, the duration of the validity, and the kind of commercialization what you can do is very, very independent, and it's actually it has its own statutes, independent statutes. So I think that's one thing what I wanted to actually mention. In addition to that, typically what he was mentioning, a patent application can be filed in 2 to 3 levels. Like typically you can see if you are an employee of an organization, you will be identified as an inventor. So you file a patent application as an employee of an organization. Or if you are on have your own firm, you can file a patent application in your own name. So typically, in a case where you are part of a bigger organization or where you're part of an organization, you will be identified only as an inventor, and the entire IP, the ownership will have will be with the company as such. Again, you can file as an individual also, where you will be not only the inventor but also the applicant. So there are various ways how you can actually secure or how you can actually use the patent processes to commercialize and take steps. NPAPP would want to explain.
Yeah. Another thing is it's not about that. Okay, I have an idea. It's new. Assume you have an idea and you have already established that, okay, this idea is, it's new, it's not obvious, it also have an industrial application. So I just go straight away apply for a I mean it's not like I just have to go and straight away apply for a patent. Imagine a scenario where you have an idea, okay, you know exactly, okay, I'm going to work on this product, this is how I am going to do it, etc. But when you apply for a patent, you have to claim the exact way in which you are going to implement that invention. Say it would take you a few months in order to achieve that kind of accuracy and for you to know, okay, this is exactly what I am about to claim. However, you have to approach, let's say, funding agency, or you have to sign MOUs with maybe some other organizations if you have to implement that idea. Okay? But you are afraid that your idea may be stolen, because you have not yet applied for a patent. So how do you overcome this kind of a situation? There is an option called, you could apply for a provisional patent application. So over there, you don't have to claim anything. It is exactly like an actual patent application, except for the claims. So it is like, let's say you want to have a house, right? Applying for a provisional application is like obtaining that land. So you are actually establishing that I am going to be operating within this one space. I am going to implement an automated illumination technology for a room. I may use these bulbs. I may use these different technologies. I am not exactly saying this is the way in which I am going to incorporate all these elements and obtain the result. But I am saying that this is the idea. This is the scope of the idea. So you can establish that scope and you can apply for a provisional application, and you get exactly 1 year's time inside which you can apply for the actual application with all the claims and, you know, the exact implementation of that idea, etc. So there are various different ways in which you could go about applying for a patent. And what about if you want to, I mean, if you are not just interested in applying in India, you also want to apply in the US or all over the world. So there are various different ways and procedures in which all of them can be done. And I think I'll hand it over to Shruti. She'll be able to explain it to us much better.
Thank you. Okay. Let me start with, you know, the slide. In India, as Arun has already clearly told you, that you can also file a provisional patent application when you are at the stage of ideation. You do not have to wait that you have the complete product in your hand. So what do you do? You first go and file a provisional patent application. before Indian Patent Office. You have 12 months from the date of provisional patent application filing to file a complete specification or a complete patent application, not only before Indian Patent Office, but before any other jurisdiction. Or you can also go for a PCT application. So you might ask me, what is a PCT application? So PCT application is a patent cooperation treaty which is signed between 148 countries. So PCT application is an international application by filing which you get the right to file before those 148 countries within the time limit of 30 or 31 months from the date of filing the provisional patent application. We suggest the PCT application only when you are intending to apply for more than 4 or 5 countries. Then it's a better option because you have lot of time to arrange your funds or to find out your potential market and just go with that. So let's say you have applied a provisional patent application in India, and within 12 months you apply a non-provisional patent application in India. What is the next step? When you apply a non-provisional application in India, you also file a request for examination along with it. Request for examination can be filed any time before 48 months from the date of filing the provisional application or the date, you know, priority date. So from the 18 months of the provisional patent application filing, the non-provisional application is published in the Patent Office Journal. So this is the phase from the when the patent is a patent application is published, anybody can oppose it. So the phase is called as pre-grant opposition. That's why it is brought into the notice of the public that if anybody has an opposition to make, they can come up and they can oppose the patent application, and the patent office will consider it and there will be arguments and a decision taken. When the examination phase comes, it is examined and the Indian Patent Office or any patent office will issue an examination report. In India, they give you 1 year of a time to sort out all the queries and respond to them and comply with all the statutory guidelines they have mentioned in the examination report. Once you complete it, they will issue a patent certificate. They will grant you the patent application. So what do you do after the patent is granted? Once the patent is granted, it just ends there. Patent is valid from the date of filing the application up to 20 years. So if you do not pay the maintenance fee after the patent is granted, you lose the right. So it is very important, even after the grant of the patent, you pay the maintenance fee every year according to the terms of the IPO rules and regulations. So as I said earlier, after the provisional application, you have 1 year to file it before India or before any jurisdiction, or go for a PCT application. So the examination process or the publication process is almost the same, except the timelines. In US also it is the same. You file an application, it is published and it is examined, you get an examination report, you resolve the queries and the patent is granted and you pay the maintenance fee. So it's the process is same throughout the jurisdiction except the timelines. PCT application is an international application. You file it and then you identify your national phase applications and you file it before those jurisdictions, and after that it is also prosecuted in the same way the Indian patent application is prosecuted or any patent application is prosecuted as per their jurisdiction. So any questions?
This always mentioned is when you're filing a patent application, you're exposing your idea to the world. So what have been the, in your experience, and you can't guarantee in the future, experiences of challenges or resulting in leakage of technology or loss of the property, intellectual property, just because of the filing? Have there been instances, and so what are the risks involved, is what I would like to ask.
See, the very system of patents, if you see the system of patents, is actually structured in such a way, it's more a contractual arrangement, you see. You as an inventor, today, you have an option to have a choice to either keep your invention as a trade secret, which most of the companies, even if you see Pepsi and Coca-Cola, they have their formulas kept as a trade secret, as against going for a patent. So it works exactly the opposite. So the way the patent system is structured is that you disclose or you go to the patent's office and you tell that this is the best way to do this patent, right? As against to that, the patent's office will tell you, okay, fine, I give you exclusive right to use this. You will be the first person to exploit this for the next 20 years. So it's a very contractual regimen, and technically speaking, if I have to read a patent document, I should be in a position to put that particular technology into use just by reading a patent document itself. So technically you have put up everything in the patent document and you're giving it to the patent's office as against your exclusive right. And there's always actually a chance of someone reading it and trying to practice it or trying to put it in action at some point of time in that particular jurisdiction. So there is really no policing system except you taking initiative and trying to keep yourself secured and with protection and to keep a check if anyone is trying to commercially exploit your patent, right? So I think it's primarily your responsibility. We spoke also in the morning. So primarily it's your responsibility, and we have come across situations where a few companies are trying to use it, not really on a commercial scale, but more trying. But again, this is again something which is really challenging as to, especially given the time frame what you have for the patent grant, and you have a challenge that you can't really enforce your right until you really have a patent grant as such.
One small related question. As an inventor, what is the rights available to me under this filing system? Of cross-examining the challenger, you know, he may be challenging my invention for frivolous grounds just to prevent me getting the patent. So what kind of a ground and what kind of a opportunity I have to challenge the challenges to my application?
See, as an inventor, if you, like as I mentioned earlier, like if you're already part of an organization, you would have, as a result of you signing an employment contract, you would have given away all your right to the organization to whom you work.
I mean
with
to the external world. So when you file your application in the patent office, they're going to invite challenges, so that technology is going to be exposed to potential challenges?
It's published. Yeah. Published. So there will be a publication stage where your application will be made available to public at large, and any person who is interested can initiate an opposition before the patent's office. And again, this is very subjective, what kind of a stand or what kind of a defense you can really take. You don't want to add something? You don't.
Sorry. No, it actually, assume for example, you have some idea and you have applied for a patent, then I over there say that no, I oppose it on what grounds, right? So I might say that no, this same idea was earlier, it was earlier said in an IEEE conference on this date in this place, this, you know, all these other proofs. So I will send all those proofs to the office. The office will then share that information with you saying you want to claim this patent, but apparently it's already out there. Answer that. So if you can establish that it's not the same or it's not the case, then you will be given a grant. If you are not able to do it, it means I'm right. That okay, this idea was already discussed. It's not novel. It's already out there in the public, so we can't give you a grant. So we can't say this is the way of doing it. Kind of it all totally depends on that matter. It's more on a case by case basis, we could say.